Welcome back, friends. So let us continue with part 6 of our revision part. So today also we will be dealing with the important awards, reports and analysis, right? So let us go and see the content. So today we will see about the United Nations report on the lead concentration. We will see about the air quality index. We will see about the deep carbon observatory. We will see about the seed award given by the UNEP. You will see about the report of the Wasteland Atlas. We will also see about the reports like brown to green report, water quality report, emission gap report by the UNEP. You will see about the indices like global climate risk index, climate change performance index, composite water management index and state energy efficiency index. And finally, we will look at India's state of forest report 2019, which is very much important for the mains perspective as well. So the first one, United Nations report on the lead concentration. So first of all, the lead concentration in paints, why it is used? It is used for various reasons, like for the color, to reduce the corrosion and to reduce the drying time. Okay, so there is a permissible limit for the lead as well, that is the 90 ppm according to the model law and guidance for regulating the lead paint. Okay, so however, it is found that only 19 countries have been following this permissible limit. Okay, so we already discussed about the UNEP and how its secretariat also providing for other conventions like CBD, Minamata. So please go through that. Okay, so the next topic is the air quality index. So this is a tool for effective dissemination regarding the information of the air quality to the general people, right? So there are 6 categories ranging from good to severe, right? So there it considers 8 pollutants, that is the particulate matter 10 and 20 2.5 NO2, SO2, carbon monoxide, ozone. See, ozone is a pollutant at the ground level, right? And ammonia and lead. Okay, so if you want to remember these things, please remember the word pollutant. You can see there is a P. From the P we have the particulate matters and the lead, right? And for the O, there are 4 O's, NO2, SO2, CO, O3, right? And finally for the N, there is NH3. Please, okay? Please do remember, there is no CO2. Okay, so UPSC generally tends to confuse you by giving the most common pollutant. Okay, so CO2, please see that this is not there in National Air Quality Index and National Ambient Air Quality Standards as well. Okay, so this air quality index is determined depending on the standards. Okay, so this National Air Quality Index has been launched in 2014 with outline of one number, one color, one description. Okay, so this is developed by CPCB with the association of IIT Kanpur. So as I said, National Ambient Air Quality Standards, apart from this 8, has other 4, total 12 pollutants, that is a nickel, arsenal, benzopyrene and benzene. Okay, so the next topic is Deep Carbon Observatory. So it has released a report on the carbon. So what is the study? Generally, the study's results are concerning about the past extinction events which are linked to the mass release of CO2. Okay, so depending on this as a core, this conducts the report on the carbon. Okay, it is found that less than 1% of the planet's carbon is found above the surface, and everything rest is found in the crust and the mantle. Okay, so it is found that the human intervention or anthropological reasons led to the greenhouse gas emissions that are 100 times greater than the emissions released by these all Earth's volcanoes. Okay, so what is it? It is a global community generally which has many scientists, and it generally deals with the origins of the carbon in Earth. Okay, so generally carbon has both positive and negative influence on the human life. Okay, so agla wala topic hai seed awards. We already discussed in the context of UNEP. So ye award is founded by the UNEP, UNDP and IUCN. So ye global partnership for the action for sustainable development and green energy. This is the sole objective for promoting. Okay, so this is originally conceived as supporting enterprises for environment and development. So iske liye 14 startups selected hue hain, theek hai. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज वेस्टलैंड एटलस. सो ये कौन देता है? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट. सो पहले बार इट हैज कंसिडर्ड द अनमैप्ड फॉरेस्ट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. ओके, सो दिस इज कैरिड अवे बाय द एनआरसी, दैट इज द नेशनल रिमोट सेंसिंग सेंटर. प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ इसरो एंड इट इज लोकेटेड इन हैदराबाद. सो इसका फाइंडिंग क्या था? सो स्पेशल एक्सटेंट ऑफ दिस वेस्टलैंड्स इन इंडिया इज 5576 मिलियन हेक्टर, दैट इज नियरली 17%. सो दिस पॉइंट में बी यूजफुल फॉर द मेन्स ऑल्सो. सी अकॉर्डिंग टू द नेशनल फॉरेस्ट पॉलिसी इंडिया एम्स एट लीस्ट 33% ऑफ अवर जियोग्राफिकल एरिया टू बी कवर्ड बाई फॉरेस्ट. सो अभी क्या है? अभी सो ओनली क्वार्टर सर, नियरली 25%. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इंक्रीज वी कैन राइट अ पॉइंट दैट वी हैव दिस मच अमाउंट इन वेस्टलैंड विच कैन बी वेस्टलैंड रिक्लेमाइजेशन करके वी कैन इंक्लूड इन दैट टू इंक्रीज द फॉरेस्ट एरिया. ओके, so previous year it is only 17%, though so it is found that this much amount of the wastelands have been converted to non wastelands. So the next report is brown to green report. This is given by the climate transparency partnership. So it does a comprehensive review of G20 countries regarding its climate performance. So it is found that the countries are shot up to 1.8% in 2018. So due to why? Because of the energy demand. So and it is also found that this energy demand is not getting cleaner. Okay, and it is found that at least for low carbon fuel may we have to increase at least 10 times by 2050 to limit by 1.5 degree limit set in Paris Agreement, right? So the next one is a water quality report. So this is in line with Jal Jeevan Mission to provide clean and safe drinking water by 2024. Okay, so how much according to this mission it is aimed at giving 55 liters per person per day. Okay, how? By tap connections. So according to this report, it is found that Delhi is not complying according to the norms, while Mumbai is found to be in accordance with the norms, right? So regarding some points about the Jal Jeevan Mission, it focuses on the integrated demand, that is the demand and supply both sides. It is based on community approach. Okay, its funding pattern, how it is with respect to center and states, it is 90-10 in Himalayan states. For North Asian states, it is 50-50. While for the United Territories it is 100%. Emission gap report, this is given by UNEP. This is also called as commitment gap. Why? So this determines where we are standing and with respect to the climate change target, that is to limit up to 1.5 or 2 degrees centigrade. Okay, so what are the findings? It is found that we will not able to achieve this target unless we reduce the greenhouse emissions by 7.6% each year. It is found if the present conditions continue, the global temperatures are set to rise by 3.2 degrees by 2100 year. Okay, so what are the top four emitters? China, USA, European Union and India. So and while India is the fourth largest emitter. Okay, so and these four itself are contributing to 55% of the emissions, greenhouse gas emissions. However, remember that this report does not include the emissions from the deforestation, that is by the land change use. So the next topic is the Global Climate Risk Index 2020. This is given by the German Watch. Okay, this is German Watch is based in Bonn, is based in Bonn and Berlin. It's an independent development and environmental organization. Okay, so what does it do in this report? It analyzes the countries affected by the impacts of weather related losses. It is found that India is the fifth most vulnerable country, and in 2018 it is found that Japan is the most hit by this climate risk. The next topic is the climate change performance index. So this index has been introduced in the UNFCCC meet that is happened in Madrid. Okay, so this is also designed by the German that's a German group, that is a German watch. So this is published in cooperation with the New Climate Initiative Climate Action Network, okay, international, and by the funding support of the Barthel Foundation. So India has been ranked as the 9th, so it is now included in the top 10. While USA is the first time, it replaces the Saudi Arabia as the worst performing country. Sweden ranks the first. The next index is about the Composite Water Management Index. This is given presently, the Composite Water Management Index 2.0 is running. So this is given by the Niti Aayog. This is given in with association with the Ministry of the Water, present now it is called Jal Shakti, and Ministry of Rural Development. Okay, so why this generates a sense of cooperative and competitive federalism, as we seen in other examples, right? So here it is found that the Gujarat continues to hold its rank 1, okay, followed by Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Goa, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So this index is developed and based on a Falcon Mark indicator of the water stress index. Okay, this is universally followed. The next important report is about the India State of Report. So this is given by the Forest Survey of India. So this was last published in 2017. It is found that the total tree and forest cover has been increased by more than 5000 square kilometers. However, it is seen that there is a loss in the northeastern state, and the reason for this has been found is shifting cultivation. The mangrove forest, however, has been seen in increase. However, it is a very less amount, that is around 1.10% from the past record, that is in 2017. So, this report also say that the Karnataka tops in the maximum amount of the forest gain. It is found this nearly quarter of the geographical area of India is covered by tree cover on the forest. The lowest forest and tree cover is seen in Haryana. Top increase, that is 97%, is in Union Territory of Lakshadweep. Okay, so UPSC tend to ask these type of questions in the ascending or the descending order. You have already asked these, I think, these two questions. So please do focus on these kind of questions, right? So forest cover with respect to the in terms of absolute area numbers, Madhya Pradesh is the first, followed by Arunachal and Chhattisgarh. While in terms of percentage, it is Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh and Meghalaya. The next index is about State Energy Efficiency Index. So this is developed by the Bureau of Energy Efficiency and the Alliance for Energy Efficient Economy. So it takes the progress of the energy efficiency initiatives by the different states and union territories. So it takes into 97 significant indicators and give that index to the states and union territories. So it has grouped into four groups depending on the performance, for forerunner, achiever, contender and aspirant. So the top best performing states are Karnataka, Himachal Pradesh, Haryana, Pondicherry. While the least performing is Manipur, Jharkhand, Rajasthan, Jammu Kashmir. So please do share your feedback. We'll be continuing with this indexes reports in one more part of this series. So till then, take care. Thank you.